Hey guys, how are you all? My name is Harshit Devedi, friends, and I welcome you back to my video. So in this video, friends, I will be talking to you about Indus Valley Civilization. This is the first video with respect to Indus Valley Civilization that I am making. In this video, I will tell you about the extent of Indus Valley Civilization, that is, in what area this Indus Valley Civilization was spread. And on the map, I will be showing you the important sites of Indus Valley Civilization like Harappa, Mohenjo-daro, and so and so. The very first important information with respect to Indus Valley Civilization is, friends, that it was actually a Bronze Age. Okay, they extensively used bronze, but they were not aware about the use of iron. So obviously they were not aware about the use of iron. They were aware about the use of bronze, and the extensive use of iron started with the extent of Vedic civilization. Okay, friends, so this is presented by me, Harshit Devedi. If you want to follow me, the link of my Instagram profile is given below. This video is in English, friends. If you want to watch the Hindi version of the video, the link of that is also given below. One important factor about this thing is, friends, that Indus Valley Civilization, this name was actually given by a person. His name was John Marshall. So John Marshall coined this name, Indus Valley Civilization. M-A-R-S-H-A-L-L, John. And this, the people of this civilization, they interacted a lot with other places. For example, they had extensive commercial and trade relationships with the people of the Mesopotamian civilization. Now, here comes a question. What were the other civilizations at that point of time? So, here you can see, friends, this Egyptian civilization on the Nile River, this Mesopotamian civilization on the Tigris-Euphrates River. There's a Tigris and Euphrates River coming like this. Then this Harappan civilization, it was in the Saraswati Valley. Okay, there was a Ghaggar-Hakar River, Saraswati River. How are the course of all of those rivers have changed now, and the Saraswati River has actually disappeared. Then here is the Chinese Huanghou Valley. So this Chinese civilization, it was on Yangtze River. So these are the important civilizations of those times, and you can very well see by the area. You know, see the black shaded area. So you by in this figure only you can see that the black shaded area is highest in this Harappan civilization. So this was the biggest. It was spread in this, you can say, this Indian subcontinent, in India, Pakistan, and a slight portion here in Iran also. So it was a quite a big civilization. Its area was around 1.3 million square kilometers. It was 1.3 million square kilometers. 13 lakh square kilometers was the area of Indus Valley civilization, friends. What was the most important rivers here? There was a river named Saraswati. There was a river named Ghaggar-Hakar. You can see this Ghaggar-Hakar river. Now this Ghaggar-Hakar river, the slight portions of this Ghaggar-Hakar river are still flowing in India and Pakistan, friends. But the course of the present Ghaggar-Hakar river, it is very much different from the course of this Ghaggar-Hakar river, which was present during the Indus Valley civilization. Also, there is a river named Saraswati. Saraswati was a very major river at that point of time when Indus Valley civilization was flourishing. Now, that Saraswati river has actually disappeared. Okay. Now, here we want to see the easternmost and the westernmost point of this Indus Valley civilization. The westernmost point of this Indus Valley civilization is Sukhta Gandhar in southern Balochistan. So here is this Balochistan in the southern, this is Balochistan, in the southern portion of this Balochistan, this is Sukhta Gandhar here, somewhere here. So this is Sukhta Gandhar, friends, and this is the western limit of this Indus Valley civilization. Similarly, if we are going to see the eastern limit of this Indus Valley civilization, there is a place named Alamgirpur in Uttar Pradesh, in the Meerut district of Uttar Pradesh. This is Alamgirpur here. So this is the easternmost boundary of Indus Valley civilization, and it is in Uttar Pradesh, friends. So this is obviously the eastern and the western periphery of Indus Valley civilization. In the north, it is said that Indus Valley civilization is extended up to Afghanistan. And in the south, it is said that it is extended up to Maharashtra state. Some excavations have given a signal that maybe this Indus Valley civilization was further south till Karnataka. But till now, it is only Maharashtra. Okay. 1400 settlements of this Indus Valley civilization have still now been, you know, excavated. 1400 settlements, and there is a chance that some more settlements will come forward. And these 1400 settlements, almost all the settlements of Indus Valley civilization were on the river bank. As I have already told you, there were four civilizations: Egypt, Mesopotamia, China, South Asia. The biggest one is Indus Valley civilization. One important factor about this Indus Valley civilization that it was said as a successor of the Neolithic site named as Mehrgarh. I talked to you about Mehrgarh in my last video, friends. So this Mehrgarh site, this was basically a Neolithic site. And this Indus Valley civilization was said to be a successor of this Mehrgarh site. Mehrgarh site was quite an urban site, friends. It was actually ahead of its time. And when Indus Valley civilization came, it was sort of urban revolution. Mehrgarh started from around 7000 BC. Now, if we talk about the time period of Indus Valley civilization, then that complete time period of Indus Valley civilization is something like this. 3300 BC to 1300 BC. Whereas when we talk about the mature force of Indus Valley civilization, it is from 2600 to 1900 BC. So basically, this is a mature phase of Indus Valley civilization, and this is a complete phase of Indus Valley civilization. So Indus Valley civilization was existing from 3300 to 1300, and mature phase was 2600 to 1900. During this, the trade centers and the places of Indus Valley civilization were flourishing. It started in 3300. From 1900 BC, it started declining, and by 1300 BC, it is said the Indus Valley civilization was completely finished. Now, moving forward, there is a theory about Proto-Dravidians. What happened, friends? It was said that when Aryans entered into the Indian subcontinent, they fought with the people of the Indus Valley civilization and they pushed these peoples of Indus Valley civilization further south. So it is said that many of these people who were previously living in Indus Valley civilization, they were sent to South India, and there they were known as Proto-Dravidians. So some scholars and some historians say that these Proto-Dravidians who are living in South India, they were actually, you know, the residents of Indus Valley civilization. They were the people who colonized Indus Valley civilization. But there is no proof of this theory. Okay, this is just a theory, friends. Now starting with the most important thing. Harappa. Where it is? It is somewhere here. See. This is Harappa. This Harappa was the first site to be discovered. See, the discovery of these sites started in a very unusual manner, friends. So, you know, these sites were discovered when the Britishers were still ruling in India. What was happening that Britishers started the work of the laying of railway lines in India. What happened one time when a railway line was being, you know, laid down in India, the workers of those railway line accidentally stumbled upon a site, and then the archaeologists were called, and when archaeologists started searching, they got to know that yes, maybe there was some sort of ancient site here where, you know, some ancient people used to live. So this is how these sites were, you can say, excavated. Harappa was the first site. It was excavated. This Harappa was excavated in 1921 by Daya Ram Sahni. Harappa in 1921 by Daya Ram Sahni. Okay, friends. Now, one important thing about this thing, this Harappa site is in present day Punjab province of Pakistan. So this is in Pakistan, and it was located on Ravi River. But friends, the current course of Ravi River and the place where this Harappa site is located, the old course of Ravi River, they are different. So it was located on an old course, on an old bed of Ravi River, this Harappa site. Okay. Now, this Harappa site becomes important, friends. A lot of things were found in this Harappa site. A lot of pottery was found. Seals were found. Terracotta figurines were found. All of these things. Then copper and bronze blade tools were found. Okay. Then weights were found. Weights were found for measuring things which are used in commercial purposes. So all of these things were found during this Harappan civilization. See, pottery, seals, terracotta figurines, tools, weights. They were found in many civilizations, and they were found in Harappa also. Then in Harappa, the concept of citadel came forward, and obviously this concept of citadel was present in almost all of the Indus Valley civilizations, leaving one or two. So basically what was happening, there was an elevated platform, and on this elevated platform a citadel was made, and this was said to be a place where important people of those civilizations used to live. And there was a road that was going down side. And downside, there was also an urban settlement where normal people used to live. So, important people used to live on a slightly elevated platform known as citadel. And then a way used to go down, and here down, some normal people used to live. There is one more important factor about Harappa, that copper bullock cart has been found in Harappa. Copper bullock cart has been found in Harappa, and there is evidence of coffin burial in Harappa. That is, they doesn't used to bury their dead directly. They used to put him in a coffin first, or her in a coffin first, and then bury him or her. So this was the way they used to operate, friends. So these are the important factors about Harappan civilization. The next civilization that we are going to talk about is Mohenjo-daro. Now, before starting about Mohenjo-daro, friends, one very important piece of information. It was founded in 1922, but first of all, we need to look at the map of Mohenjo-daro. Here, this is Mohenjo-daro, and you can see it is very near to Indus River. But still, the course of Indus River, with respect to the course of Indus River at that point of time, is slightly different. So, this Mohenjo-daro was in Indus River. It was also known as Sindh River. It is in Pakistan. So, presently, the Mohenjo-daro site is in Pakistan only. Now, important factors about Mohenjo-daro. The site, as I already told you, it was found in 1922 by R.D. Banerjee. Okay. Where it is? Obviously on Indus River in Pakistan's Larkana district. L-A-R-K-A-N-A. It was in Larkana district of Pakistan, friends. Okay. Now, what are the important factors of Mohenjo-daro? See, friends, in Mohenjo-daro, Great Bath is found. Now, have a look at this Great Bath. This is the Great Bath of Mohenjo-daro, friends. It was something like this. This much is 6 meters and this much is 12 meters. So, this was 6 by 12 meters specimen of beautiful brickwork. On the floor of this Great Bath, bricks are there and burnt bricks are there. So, basically, burnt bricks were used. Mortar was used. Gypsum was used. So these were the elements used to make this Great Bath, the magnum opus Great Bath. Obviously, important people used to come here and bath. This was obviously the, you know, rationale behind making this thing. And one important factor about this Great Bath you need to remember is that stone was not used in making this Great Bath. So no, there was no use of stone. Obviously, there was use of burnt bricks, mortar and gypsum, friends. So this is one important finding of Mohenjo-daro. Then there is one few more important findings of Mohenjo-daro, friends. One is the bronze dancing girl. This is a bronze dancing girl which was found in Mohenjo-daro. This shows that some social entertainment activities were also going on in Mohenjo-daro. Then few more important things are found in Mohenjo-daro. The supposed seal of Pashupati. Okay, I will come on to this seal after some amount of time, friends. This Pashupati or Proto Shiva seal, this was very important. Okay, what the things which are in these seal, I will be discussing after some time in the later part of the video. Then this is the, you can say, the statue of a bearded priest. This has also been found from Mohenjo-daro. You can see the priest here. The priest here is, you know, having a shawl like thing on his shoulder. And his left shoulder is covered with this shawl, and his right hand is bare. It is not covered with the shawl. So this is something like a fashion here. This shawl is covering his left hand, but not the right hand. This may be the way of, you can say, wearing a shawl at that point of time by people, or especially by the priest. So these are the suppositions that have been made by the historians and the scholars while deciphering all of these things. Okay, friends. Then a lot of other terracotta figurines have also been found from Mohenjo-daro, and seals are found, pottery and found, the general things are found everywhere. For example, this pottery and seals and terracotta figurines, tools, weights have also been found from Mohenjo-daro. Okay, then moving forward, friends, there is an important site named as Kalibangan. Kalibangan is present in the Hanumangarh district of Rajasthan. Coming back to map, can you spot Kalibangan? Yes, this is Kalibangan friend somewhere here. So basically this is in Rajasthan. Kalibangan. It is in Rajasthan. Actually, it is in Hanumangarh district of Rajasthan. It is located on the banks of Saraswati River. So, all the three important rivers I have told you. See friends, all the important sites, the bank of those rivers I will also telling you on whose rivers bank they were there. So, this may be a question. And actually, this Kalibangan civilization flourished for 5 centuries, around 500 years. So, you can say that this Saraswati River was actually a very important river at that point of time. This Kalibangan site was it was founded by an archaeologist named Liugi Pio Tessitori. Liugi Pio Tessitori. So name of the archaeologist was okay. So this was a person who founded this site, and this site was extensively excavated by A. Ghosh. Okay, moving forward. What are the important findings at Kalibangan? First of all, proof of earthquake has been found in Kalibangan. So this is one important thing about Kalibangan. Fire altars have been found in Kalibangan. Second important thing, John. Then two kinds of burial was found here. The graves. There are circular graves. There are rectangular graves. So people were buried in circular graves also. People were buried in rectangular graves also. Then the bones of camels have also been found here. Camel bone. So this is one more important factor about Kalibangan. However, Kalibangan was not considered a plant city. What was the reason that Kalibangan was not a plant city and Mohenjo-daro and Harappa were plant city? See friends, the bricks used in Kalibangan were not burnt bricks. They were not burnt bricks, and they were earthen bricks. E-A-R-T-H-E-N. Now the difference between this burnt bricks and earthen bricks is that the quality of burnt bricks is much better than the quality of earthen bricks, because burnt bricks have already been treated in that, you know, hot platform bhatti, and obviously because of that they are very powerful. So that is why burnt bricks are better than quality from earthen bricks. Earthen bricks are less in quality and burnt bricks are better in quality. So if you are using burnt bricks, obviously it will be a better. But the people of Kalibangan were not using, you know, the burnt bricks, the baked bricks. They were using the earthen bricks. So that is why they were not being said as a well-planned city. The second thing was that, friends, that there was no drainage system in Kalibangan. In the other colonies of Indus Valley Civilization, what was happening, that a sort of drainage system was developed. You can say, na, in Hindi it is said as Nali. The sewers. So obviously from the side of the houses, in all the other Indus Valley Civilization sites, sewers used to go out, and the waste water and things of waste could flow through that sewers and go to a common, you can say, waste collection point. But in Kalibangan, there was no such drainage system developed, and that is why Kalibangan was not said as a well-planned city. The next city that we are going to talk about is Dholavira, friends. Okay. This Dholavira location, it is located in Run of Kutch in Gujarat. Have a look at this Dholavira. You can see this is Dholavira, friends, and it is very related to Run of Kutch, Gujarat. Very near to Run of Kutch, Gujarat. Now, what are the important factors about Dholavira, friends? Dholavira, it was excavated in 1990s by R.S. Bist. Okay. And one important factor about this Dholavira is, friends, that, see, if we talk about the most important cities of the Indus Valley Civilization, so we have already talked about Mohenjo-daro, Harappa. This is also a very important city of Indus Valley Civilization. It is a nuclear city of Indus Valley Civilization. It was quite developed. It has big reservoirs, big drainage system, and a whole lot of things were present in this Dholavira. So you can say that Dholavira was a nuclear city, was a very important city of Indus Valley Civilization. This is one important factor about Dholavira. Then Dholavira had fortifications around its citadel. So this is the top, and here is the citadel. And from the citadel, way is going down. There are normal habitations. So there were fortifications on the outside of these citadels also, and on the inside of these citadels also. Fortifications is a lot of type of fort, protecting it from aggression or things like that. But actually, there was no aggression at that point of time. It was just a protective covering. So these fortifications were present in the citadels of Dholavira, friends. An internal fortification, internal closure of fortification was also there in Dholavira. That is not an important piece of information here. One very important piece of information when we talk about Dholavira is an Indus script. A signboard with Indus script has been has been excavated from Dholavira. This is that sign in this script which has been excavated from Dholavira. You can see some figures are here. This is actually something like this. So these are the figures, and this is said to be the script of Indus Valley Civilization. So you can see that it is a very pictographic script, but unfortunately this script has not been deciphered, friends. You can see this is a sort of wheel, a hammer, things like these are there in this, but nobody actually knows what these things are. It has still not been deciphered and it has been found in Dholavira. Okay, then the next we are going to talk about is Lothal. Okay, now when we talk about port town, friends, so there are three port towns coming to our mind. Three important port towns. One is Lothal here. Previously it was near to the bank of sea, but now due to coastal erosion and things like that, coastal erosion, coastal upliftment, it is shifted quite inside the land. So this is Lothal. Then Sukta Gandhar, I already shown you. See, Sukta Gandhar is around 55 kilometers from the sea right now. At that point of time, Sukta Gandhar was a port town. But now Sukta Gandhar is not a port town. It is 55 kilometers from the Arabian Sea. And similarly, there is a place Balakot. Now this Balakot is on the sea only. So at that point of time, Balakot was also a port town. Today also Balakot is a port town. So these three, Sukta Gandhar here, Balakot here, and Lothal here, these were three important port towns of those Indus Valley Civilization time. Okay, so all the three locations of these three ports I have already shown you. Coming back, first of all, we are going to talk about Lothal. So Lothal was an important dock site and an important port town in the Indian territory. Currently, fences Sukta Gandhar and Balakot both are in Pakistan. Lothal is the only dockyard, artificial dockyard or port town of Indus Valley Civilization, which is on the side of India, friends. Okay. And there are, you know, proper proofs where it is said that yes, Lothal used to trade with Mesopotamia. The people of Indus Valley Civilization through Lothal dockyard used to trade with Mesopotamian, friends. Iranian seals have been found in Indus Valley Civilization. Similarly, the seals of Harappan Civilization have also been found in Mesopotamia. Also, friends, one important factor about this Lothal, that the city Lothal was divided into six sections. This is something unique, which is not present in other civilizations. Okay, and one important factor about Lothal was that the entry to the houses were on main street. See, suppose this is a road, main road. It was a well-planned city. On this main roads, people are moving, this bullock carts are moving, all of these things are moving. Here are the houses of people. Now, in the Lothal, the gates of the houses used to open on the main street. Whereas in other Indus Valley Civilization sites, the gates were from side, from back, something lateral, not on the main street. So in other Indus Valley Civilization, the entry to the house was not on the main street, it was from side or back. But in Lothal, the entry to the house was from the main street. So this is an important factor about Lothal civilization. So if a question like this is asked to you, that in which Indus Valley Civilization site the entry to the houses was from the main street, the answer would be Lothal. Okay, now moving forward, the next we are going to talk about is Sukta Gandhar. Sukta Gandhar, I have already shown you on the map, friends. Sukta Gandhar, one important factor, that it is currently around 55 kilometers from the Arabian Sea. This thing you should know, friends. Moving forward, it is near to the Iran border. It is the westernmost part of the Indus Valley Civilization. And now it is not on the sea because of coastal upliftment and erosion. Okay. So this is an important factor about Sukta Gandhar. Next, we are going to talk about sites Kot Diji. Okay. We should come on this map only, friends. Okay, so basically, where is this Kot Diji? You can see this Kot Diji somewhere here. So it is located on the bank of Indus River, this Kot Diji. Okay, Kot Diji. It is said that many statues of bull and mother goddess have been found in Kot Diji. See, mother goddess is a very recurring phenomena in Indus Valley Civilization, and the seals of mother goddess have been found throughout the Indus Valley Civilization. Okay, then there's Roper in Punjab. This is Roper, friends. So this Roper was excavated by YD Sharma. not that much important piece of information. Okay. Roper is in Punjab. There's a site near Roper named Bara. This Bara is not shown here. So let us leave that. Then friends, we will talk about a place named as Chanhudaro. Can you search Chanhudaro? This is Chanhudaro. Somewhere here. Okay. So you can see that it is also on the bank of Indus River. It is located 130 kilometers south of Mohenjo-daro. So this is Chanhudaro and this is Mohenjo-daro. So this is the distance is 130 kilometers, friends. Okay. And a lot of figurines, toys, bone implements is also found in Chanhudaro. Chanhudaro is also on Sindh River. Then we will talk about a site named Banavali. This is Banavali site. This Banavali is an important site in Hisar, Haryana. Okay. Barley, high quality barley storage sites have been found in Banavali. Then we will talk about Alamgirpur. Alamgirpur I have shown initially only. This is the easternmost extent of Indus Valley Civilization, friends. In Banavali, a lot of fossils of plants, bones of animals, pottery, copper tools, bronze tools have been found in Alamgirpur. Then a very important site is Surkotra. Surkotra is in Gujarat, friends. Can you find this Surkotra? This is Surkotra. Why is Surkotra famous? Surkotra is famous because a lot of horse bones have been found in Surkotra. So that is why this Surkotra become important, friend. Also, then we will talk about a place named, you can say Rangpur. This is Rangpur and this Rangpur site is also in Gujarat, friends. Okay. Then there's a Rakhi Gadhi site. This Rakhi Gadhi site is in, you can say Haryana. So kindly remember Rakhi Gadhi site. Rakhi Gadhi site is the largest Indus Valley site on the Indian side and it is in Haryana, friends. So these are the important sites of Indus Valley civilization that I've shown you on the map. All important factors I've also shown you on the map, friends. And in the very next video, I will be telling you about how the administration used to go on Indus Valley civilization, friends. The important sites of Indus Valley civilization I've shown you. Okay. The few important sites you need to remember, a slight idea about these sites on the map will help you remember them, on whose rivers bank these rivers were located. And by looking at these, you know, sites in this map also, you can assume that on whose river, on the bank of which river these sites were located. However, this is not that much important. The information regarding the sites which I have given you in this video is very much enough for your exams perspective. Okay. So here I will finish this important sites video of Indus Valley civilization, friends. In the next video, friends, I will be talking about life at Indus Valley civilization. So I am currently ending this video now, friends. If you really like this video, kindly subscribe to my channel. Kindly like this video. Through your comments, tell me that how you are liking this video, friends, and please share these videos on your Facebook profile, on your Instagram profile. That will help me to get a few amount of views. So thank you for watching this video, friends. Have a great day and goodbye.